students, in the previous class we have seen response of an undamped system to harmonic excitation, and in this particular class what we are going to do is we are going to have a look at those systems which have got damping into it. Okay, we already have derived the expression of that. So what we have said previously is that x, which is the displacement of the mass in that system which has got a damping into it, is decomposed into two parts. One is xc and the other one is xp. xp is the particular integral, and xp is of this form. xp, as we have discussed, is equal to x, which is the amplitude of that, times cosine of omega t minus phi, where, as I just now said, x is the amplitude and phi is the phase angle. And this is the phase difference with respect to forcing. So let's say if this is the forcing, we are talking about a forcing which is cosine cosine wave it is. So this is f0 cosine omega t, which is force. Okay, if this is the force, then xp would look something like this. Okay, it will be another wave which has got a similar frequency, circular frequency, which is that of omega. However, there is a slight phase difference between these two, and that phase difference is characterized by this phi, and the amplitude of the displacement, this xp part of the displacement, is this one, okay, x. And we already have discussed that this x happens to be equal to f0 by k, which is delta st, that is static displacement, divided by under root 1 minus omega by omega n square plus 2 xi omega by omega n square. Okay, generally what we do is we use this omega for this ratio omega by omega n, we use a parameter called as R. So R represents omega by omega n. Okay, so if I use that, then I'll be writing down x by xxt or delta st, that is the ratio of amplitude of this particular integral to this static deflection, that is equal to 1 over under root 1 minus R square plus 2 xi r the whole square. Okay, this is what is this ratio, which is also called as a magnification factor. Okay, so this is the factor by which this delta st is magnified. So this is the result of having r non-zero, that is having such kind of forcing which is varying in time, which is having this harmonic variation. So because of this variation of the forcing, what has happened is that this amplitude has got increased, and by how much amount? By this magnification factor. And that magnification factor is having this kind of an expression, okay, which is equal to 1 over this term. Okay, this term is square root of 1 plus r square the whole square plus 2 xi r square. Okay, this is what is the ratio of the this amplitude with respect to delta st, which is called as a magnification factor. And the other parameter which appears over here, and we have derived expression of that as well, is the phi, which is that phase difference that I just now talked about, phase difference between this forcing function and this displacement part, that is the xp part of the displacement. Okay, so phase difference between them is phi, which is equal to tan inverse of 2 xi, we have omega by omega n over here, I'll be writing down r directly for that. So it is 2 xi r divided by 1 minus r square. Okay, this is what is the expression of phi. So depending on what is the value of xi that the system is having, and depending on what is the forcing frequency that we are applying, that is what is r, based on that, so this phi will be determined, and also this magnification factor will be determined. This is this part of the displacement, which is xp part of the displacement. But as I just now have told you, that x is equal to xc plus xp. So वी नीड टू टेक केयर ऑफ एक्स सी एज वेल इन ऑर्डर टू कम्प्लीटली डिफाइन एक्स. सो एक्स सी इज कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री सोल्यूशन विच डिपेंड्स ऑन हाउ मच जाई इज देर. सो इफ जाई इज स्मॉलर देन वन, इफ जाई इज इक्वल टू वन, और इफ जाई इज ग्रेटर देन वन. सो फॉर ऑल दोज वैल्यूज लेट से विच आर फॉर विच जाई इज स्मॉलर देन वन, दैट इज वी आर कंसिडरिंग एन अनडैम्प्ड केस. ओके सॉरी एन अंडरडैम्प्ड केस. इन दैट केस वॉट इज गोइंग टू हैपन इज दैट वी आर गोइंग टू गेट दिस एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ एक्स सी. सो लेट मी ट्राई टू राइट डाउन दैट एक्सप्रेशन. ई रेस टू माइनस जाय ओमेगा एन टी टाइम्स ए टाइम्स कोसाइन ऑफ ओमेगा डी टी माइनस साय. ओके प्लस दिस इज एक्स सी पार्ट and we have xp part over here, and xp part is what we have just now written, which is this one. Okay, so which is equal to x cosine of omega t minus phi. Okay, this phi, as I just now told you, is the phase difference between the force and xp. Okay, whereas this is a phase difference, or this is a phase of this part, xc part. Okay, so let's say if this is what is xc, okay, excluding this part, okay, I've not included this part, damping part. Okay, this is only the oscillatory portion of xc. Okay, if this is what is the oscillatory portion of xc, we already have seen that it can be, so this variation, okay, can be captured by an equivalent phase diagram. Okay, so where this vector represents this magnet, this x c, okay, and its projection over here is what is this, right? And this angle is omega dt minus psi, and psi is where this vector was at time t equal to 0. So this vector will be somewhere over here, depending on what are the initial conditions that we are providing. So this was the initial position of that, and hence this angle is what is psi. Okay, so this is the angle with respect to x axis. Okay, in the beginning, that is when time t was equal to 0 at that time. So where this vector was, okay, this is again the same vector, xc vector, okay, whose projection over here on the x axis is what is the displacement, this displacement component that we are getting, right? So this angle is this angle psi, whereas this phi angle is the difference between this force vector and xp. So the way we are representing xc over here, we can also represent xp in the similar fashion. Okay, so xp, let's say, is somewhere over here, okay, whereas force will be somewhere over here, and this much amount of the angle this force vector has traversed in time t. Okay, so let's say this is f, and this is equal to omega t, this part, whereas this angle is omega dt minus phi. Okay, and this is xp vector. Okay, and this difference between these two angles is what is this phi. Okay, you need to appreciate the difference between what is this psi, which is appearing over here, and what is phi, which is appearing over here. Okay, so what we are going to do is, in the next class, when we'll be done with this particular session, in the next session I'll be once again revisiting this phasor diagrams for this harmonic excitation case, and we are going to have a closer look at all these things once again. Okay, so now let's assume for time being that these phase angles which are coming over here in these expressions, one is the psi and the other one is this phi. Okay, so this is what is the expression of x. Now this xc part, as we already have seen, is that part which dies down with time, something like this, right? Depending on how much is the I value, so it will die down. Okay, whereas this is xp part, विच इज़ ऑसिलेटरी इन नेचर एंड ऑसिलेट्स विथ अ फ्रीक्वेंसी विच इज़ द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ एक्साइटेशन फोर्स. वेयर एज दिस पार्ट विच इज़ एक्सी पार्ट के दिस इज़ ऑसिलेटिंग विथ अ फ्रीक्वेंसी इक्वल टू ओमेगा डी, राइट, सर्कुलर फ्रीक्वेंसी ओमेगा डी, एंड दिस इज ऑसिलेटिंग विथ सर्कुलर फ्रीक्वेंसी ओमेगा विच इज़ द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ एक्सटर्नल एक्साइटेशन. दिस इज एक्स पी, दिस इज एक्स सी, एंड कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ बोथ ऑफ देम इज वॉट इज द एक्चुअल डिसप्लेसमेंट. सो वॉट एक्चुअल डिसप्लेसमेंट वुड लुक लाइक, सो यू हैव दिस वन बेसिक वेव ओवर योर विच इज़ दैट ऑफ एक्स पी, एंड ऑन टॉप ऑफ दैट दिस वेव, ऑन टॉप ऑफ दिस बेसिक वेव विच इज दिस वेव, ऑन टॉप ऑफ दैट यू हैव दिस अदर वाइब्रेशन रिकॉर्डेड ओवर योर विच इज सपोज टू डाई डाउन विद टाइम, एम्पलीट्यूड ऑफ दैट डाइज डाउन, एंड इवेंचुअली यू कैन से दैट वॉट इज लेफ्ट विथ इज ओनली एक्स पी, एक्स सी हैज डाइड डाउन बाई दिस टाइम. ओके, सो हियर आफ्टर वॉट रिमेन्स इज ओनली एक्स पी. That's why this XP is also called as a steady state response. So let's say you have kind of let some good amount of time to pass. So let's say that you started this experiment in the morning slot, and then in the afternoon slot you are having a look at it. Okay, not this but this big time span generally we refer to, but in order to just tell you an example, I am telling you that let's say that some good amount of time has got passed, so that all this XC part, okay, which we call as transient part, that transient part has died down, and now what we are left with is only this XP, which is called as a steady state part. Okay, and that is the part which is oscillating exactly with the same frequency as that of the forcing frequency, and now in the steady state part there is no any contribution of initial conditions. So we already have seen that XP is indifferent to initial conditions. Initial conditions only come over here in this XC. Okay, there is no any contribution of those initial conditions over here. So which essentially means that steady states are indifferent to initial conditions. Initial conditions will only play their role in that, in this transient part. Once the transient part dies down after some good amount of time, then what you will be left will be the steady state part, and it will be indifferent to initial conditions. It will be function of system parameter, what are your system parameters, which are xi and omega n, and it will be oscillating, it will again be harmonic, and it will be oscillating with this circular frequency omega, okay, which is the frequency of external forcing. Okay, so now hence what we are going to do is we are going to consider that that's the only displacement that is left with us. Okay, so we don't have this transient part now to look after. Okay, so we are over here after. Okay, so we don't have to kind of consider what has happened because of these initial conditions, and XC is something that will be completely neglecting, and we'll be left with only this one, okay, which is this steady state part. Okay, so in that case, so that's why we'll be having in detail look at that steady state part alone. Okay, so now let me try to draw how exactly that magnification curve will change with respect to omega by omega n. Okay, so let's try to see to it that how that steady state response is for various values of xi and omega by omega n. So for various values of xi, how exactly that amplitude of that steady state response changes with omega by omega n is something that we are having a look at. So we already have done for xi equal to 0, so we this is magnification factor, or x by xxt or delta st, whatever that you prefer calling. Okay, I am writing down x over here, okay, which is amplitude of ideally only xp part. Okay, xc part is something that we are neglecting. Okay, so amplitude of that displacement, okay, which will be the only displacement that we'll be left with. Okay, now that amplitude, as we have seen, for xi equal to 0 starts from 1, builds up continuously and shoots to infinity over here for ओमेगा बाय ओमेगा एन, दैट इज दिस आर वैल्यू इक्वल टू वन. एज आर इंक्रीजेस फर्दर दिस ड्रॉप्स डाउन दिस वैल्यू ऑफ मैग्निफिकेशन फैक्टर एंड स्लोली इट रीचेस टू ज़ीरो. दिस इज द स्टोरी ऑफ ज़ाय इक्वल टू ज़ीरो. नाउ लेट्स ट्राई टू हैव सर्टन डैम्पिंग इन टू इट. लेट्स से दैट समथिंग लाइक 0.3 और 0.2 और समथिंग लाइक दैट, सम गुड अमाउंट ऑफ डैम्पिंग. इन दैट केस वॉट विल हैपन इज दैट यू कैन प्लॉट दिस एंड जस्ट सी टू इट इफ इट हैपन्स दैट वे. ओके, सो यू विल बी एबल टू सी टू इट दैट द ग्राफ विल लुक लाइक दिस. दिस इज द न्यू ग्राफ. लेट मी ट्राई टू ड्रॉ इट विथ अनादर कलर. ओके, रेड कलर. दिस इज फॉर साई विच इज लार्जर देन ज़ीरो, दैट इज फॉर सर्टन डैम्पिंग दैट वी हैव इंक्लूडेड ओवर हियर. ओके, सो वॉट हैज़ हैपन्ड इज दैट, सो बिकॉज ऑफ एडिशन ऑफ द डैम्पिंग, वन थिंग दैट हैज़ सर्टनली हैपन्ड इज दैट amplitude is no more infinity at any location. Whatever be the r value, amplitude will not go to infinity. You will even be able to see to it from the expression. Okay, so let me show you the expression which is over here. So even a smallest xi value, okay, if you add over here, so whatever be this value of r, this denominator will not be zero completely because xi will always be there. So even if this becomes zero, this will not be zero. So some value of this denominator will be certain non-zero value will remain, and hence this amplitude will always be finite. Okay, that is one thing that has happened. And second thing that has happened is that the peak of this amplitude variation, that this magnification variation, has shifted towards this side. Okay, so peak which was over here for xi equal to 0, it was for 1, and now as we have changed the xi further, we have increased the xi to certain value which is 0.3 over here, something like 0.3. okay, I've drawn a kind of a schematic one. Okay, it is not the exact curve. You can draw it by yourself on MATLAB or something like that on Excel and just try it out if it comes out in a similar fashion. Okay, and you will be able to appreciate that the peak value shifts towards this side. Okay, so where is this peak appearing? Peak is appearing, you will be able to appreciate that this peak is there where dm, this m is this magnification factor, dm by dr will be equal to 0. Okay, so wherever this thing is happening where dm and dm by dr is coming out to be equal to 0, that is the point where peak is appearing. Okay, so if you further increase xi, let me increase xi further. Okay, so this is what is going to happen. Peak will further shift over here towards this side. And one more thing that has happened is that peak is also peak value is also going down. For xi equal to 0, peak was infinity. For xi which is larger than 0, peak value is something over here, and now even for larger value of xi, we are getting peak value over here. Okay, so what we'll do is, in order to find out that, okay, we need to differentiate. So let me go back to the original one, original color. Okay, so this you know expression for magnification factor, right? Magnification factor expression is this: 1 over 1 minus r square square plus 2 xi r square. Okay, this is the expression for magnification factor. So what you need to do is, you need to differentiate dm with respect to r and put it equal to 0, okay, for certain chosen value of xi. Okay, for fixed value of xi, so you need to see where this thing happens. Okay, and you will be able to see to it that this happens for that value of xi which is equal to that value of r which is equal to under root 1 minus 2 xi square. Okay, so for, let's say, for xi equal to 0.3, it will be equal to 1 minus 2 into 0.3 square. Okay, so for this value, okay, 0.3, this is what is r. You have to find out the r value from here, and you will be able to see that at that r value you are getting the maxima of that peak. Okay, so and it also tells us that with increasing xi, this maximum value is going to, this r is going to shift towards over here, and we also need to find out what is maximum m at that particular r. Okay, if you put this value of r in this expression, then you will be able to see that m comes out to be equal to 1 over 2 xi into 1 minus xi square. Okay, so this is what is m. Okay, and this m is infinity for xi equal to 0. And for any other value of xi, this m is a finite number, okay, and it comes down. However, there is one threshold over here, you will be able to see to it that you are going to find this maxima only up to certain limit, okay, and only up to certain value of xi. Okay, because this maxima appears at this location when r is equal to under root 1 minus 2 xi square. Okay, when 1 minus 2 xi square is equal to 0, or xi increases even further so that this becomes negative, at that location dm by dr will not be equal to 0, or it won't be it won't exist at all. Okay, and the maximum value will occur over here itself. Okay, and hence for all higher value of xi, you will be able to see that this is how the response would look like. Okay, that is, peak value will be over here itself, 1 will be the highest one. Okay, thereafter you are going to see that amplitude reduces continuously. Okay, whatever be the value of this r, amplitude is going to reduce, it won't see a peak. It will see a peak only up to this limit. Okay, that is only up to xi, which is smaller than 1 over square root of 2. Okay, till the time xi is within this range, you are going to see a peak, that is from 0 to this. Okay, otherwise there won't be any peak. Okay, the moment xi becomes 1 over square root of 2, then this dm by dr equal to 0, this condition is appearing over here, that is at r equal to 0, and thereafter it doesn't exist. Okay, so there is you won't be able to see any point over here where slope is 0. Okay, so that doesn't exist at all. Okay, so this is how the magnification factor curves look like. Okay, and this is for increasing value of xi increasing value. Okay, now what we'll do is we'll stop over here for this particular session, and in next session we are going to have a detailed look at phi, okay, which is the phase angle, and in that class itself we are going to talk about phasor diagram. Okay, so we'll be stopping over here. Thank you.